They feel Giguere has their back.
And as much as they'd like to get Jonas Gustafsson in a game, they'll win this one and pretty much a lock that he's not playing for a little while. Maybe in New York late next week.
They only play back-to-back twice the first month. There'll be a spot for him, but it's not the first few games here.
They'll have to work hard in practice. Jason Spezza spinning, running out of time, passes off. Daniel Albertson in front of Chris Campoli. Sergei Gonchar backs up. Albertson's slap pass tipped off the side of the net by Spezza, who scored the lone goal. Gonchar with a shot. Loose puck at the side of the net after the Giguere save. And the Senators track it down again. Francois Beauchemin just trying to kill some time in the corner. Centering pass, Albertson fanned. Brown shoots the puck down the ice. And the Leafs go 2-0. Tonight, the Leafs were the better team and win 5-1.
Yeah, it's early to be judging, but this Maple Leaf team, the most organized we've seen in a while. A good start for them all around. And Corey Kluston, back-to-back games, really questioning his team's team play and their effort.
Took the Leafs a minute and 38 to win this hockey game. They were far more battle-ready in the Battle of Ontario. Only one team showed up, the team in blue.
And the team in blue got its second win of last season on the 6th of November. They've got two a month ahead of that time on October 9th. Ron?
Jim, thanks kindly. Another team in blue. The Vancouver Canucks getting set for a big night. First up, our Crown Royal three stars of the two early games at Toronto. Phil Kessel, a goal and an assist. Tim Brent scored a goal. Four shots on goal, two block shots, and Christopher Stieg, 1-1. Goal and an assist. Toronto wins it in a romp.